Good morning, students. Today I am starting with chapter 4, India's External Relations, from the book Politics in India Since Independence. So if we are talking about the past three chapters from this book, we read about all the internal challenges which India were facing, right? After independence, the goal of India was to achieve unity, democracy and development. And how were these challenges and how were India battling to achieve these goals? Now, within that time when India was actually looking at its internal matter, it was also important to deal with the external matter and have its own foreign policy. So in this chapter we will deal about what kind of foreign policy did India had, how was India dealing with the foreign affairs, and under what circumstances a foreign policy was influenced by and was formed. Okay, so looking at the brief, you can even look at this picture wherein Nehru, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, is actually standing with all the NAM leaders. Okay, the names are mentioned here. And in this chapter we will basically discuss about the non-alignment policy, or the non-alignment movement we can say, which was our one major factor which decided our foreign policy. You know, one major important feature of our foreign policy at the time of independence is non-alignment only. Okay, then how did our foreign policy was framed when we gained independence? During the initial years only, we had three wars. We had war in 1962, in 1965 and in 1971. Okay, and beside that all, we have to form our foreign policy and the entire thing about India's relation with China and Pakistan. Okay, how, since the world was divided between the US and the USSR, so they were inclined towards the nuclear weapons. So what was India's stand on nuclear weapons, and how did we sorted to maintain relations between our external and our internal policy, and what basically shaped our external relations, what were our principles, and everything related to our foreign policy we will discuss in this chapter. So let us start the chapter through its introduction only. It talks about international context. So you need to understand, when India gained independence, what were the things happening around the world? You know, foreign policy can be individual policy. Every country has their own individual foreign policy. But a foreign policy of a country will always be influenced by other things which are happening in the world and by your immediate neighbors. Okay, so when India gained independence, that time, you know, it was a very challenging international arena going on. The time was really difficult. The international time was really difficult. The world had witnessed a devastating wars, okay, and was grappling with the issues of reconstruction. Yet another attempt to establish an international body was underway. Many new countries were emerging as a result of collapse of colonialism, and most new nations were trying to come to terms with the twin challenge of welfare and democracy. So what were the things happening in the international arena? So the world has already witnessed what? World wars, okay, which were devastating wars. Then the economies were trying to reconstruct themselves because they had so much loss during the wars. Also, there was now requirement for a new international body, okay, or international forum. Many countries were getting freedom from colonialism, so there was an end of colonialism. New countries were coming, and within these new countries there was a challenge of welfare and democracy. All the countries wanted to establish democracy and wanted to acquire welfare. Now, within that time, Indian foreign policy was actually a free policy. Okay, free policy मतलब India की अपनी policy थी foreign policy को लेकर. Nobody had actually decided for India. India decided its own foreign policy. So free India's foreign policy reflected all these concerns in the period immediately after independence. Apart from these factors at the global level, India had its own share of concerns. Okay, now when India gained independence, all these things were already happening in the world. Now apart from that, India had their own concerns. Okay, India ke apne bhi concerns the India को अपने इकोनॉमी को देखना था, अपने लोगों को देखना था, हैड टू लुक इन द वेलफेयर ऑफ द पीपल एंड एवरीथिंग. द ब्रिटिश गवर्नमेंट लेफ्ट बिहाइंड द लेगेसी ऑफ मेनी इंटरनेशनल डिस्प्यूट्स. पार्टीशन क्रिएटेड इट्स ओन प्रेशर एंड द टास्क ऑफ पॉवर्टी एलिवेशन वॉज ऑलरेडी वेटिंग फॉर फुलफिलमेंट. So when all these things were happening in international order, okay, India was also facing with its own difficulties. India had just faced partition, which was already a trauma to India, okay. And then when Britishers went, so they also left a legacy behind and all the disputes they had with the other countries, plus the internal matters of India. This was the overall context in which India started participating in the world affairs as an independent nation state. So this is, you know, a short history to when India started participating in the international arena. So what were the situations? India ka apna situation bhi bahut worst tha. India was grappling with a lot of partition issues. That was also a trauma. And at the same time, India ne new independence gain kiya tha. So looking everything in the mind and Pakistan was its immediate neighbor, China, and all these things actually amalgamated to form India's national policy. As a nation born in the backdrop of the World War, India decided to conduct its foreign relations with an aim to respect the sovereignty of all other nations and to achieve security through the maintenance of peace. This aim finds an echo in the directive principles of state policy. Now they are saying since when India was born, already there was a lot of world war going on. There was an immediate period of Cold War when India attained independence. So India basically respected its principle of sovereignty and others also, and actually it did not join any kind of wars. And for India, its immediate concern was to maintain security, to make India secure, and to maintain peace. Okay, and they are saying actually these, to maintain peace and security are also mentioned in our directive principles of state policy as well, in our constitution.